budget, and we turn civil to the Vice President of Council, Paul Zetsky, to lead us through the budget.
Mr. President, it'd be my pleasure to facilitate the review of the 2017 budget. I just ask that someone make a motion to vote to accept my duties.
Motion by the chair.
Second.
Second by Councilman Manero. Paul Zetsky, to lead us through the budget. Any further discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call on this.
Ms. Alves, yes. Mr. Bushen.
Yes.
Mrs. Hamel.
Yes.
Mr. Sol.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, council members, for your vote of confidence in your help throughout this process. Before we begin, I'd like to ask the budget committee, is there anything that we've seen a change in revenues of roughly $69,000, I believe, $62,000. Is that right from the original budget? And we're going to be working off of the revised budget of June 9th quarter.
June 6th, I believe, was the date we published that additional information.
And June 9th was the revision, correct? Okay. Anything you wish to add before we start?
Just the fact that the budget that you see before you tonight, it's a plan of operations for the coming fiscal year, and we hope that you've taken a number of things into consideration as we put it together. We met with the town administrator and her administration, the department heads, the school department administration, the school committee. We've gone over capital items with the planning board line by line, all in our efforts to listen to and understand what the needs for this town will be for the coming year. I think we have also come up with a plan in the event there are some issues that befall the town during the ensuing year, that you will have the flexibility to take care of those items. I think we've already enumerated a number of them, which are the move with the Bushy School and Town Hall and Kendall Dean, the fact that the police contract has yet been resolved, other items that have come up, you've already taken care of some of them, the issue too of school capital, if you wish to expand the amount there. I think things we've also heard is that there may be money needed for playground upgrades, matches for grants, additional work not able to be covered by grant funds. We've taken care of the EMA reserve fund tonight. There's also the economic desert of the development company, the Economic Development Commission that was looking for a $10,000 figure that we did not get into research to where that all came from and went to, but at some point you may be asked to come up with that kind of money. So this then is our plan, our budget, for you to consider and adopt for the upcoming year. It is a plan that we feel enables you with the right tickets for flexibility. Thank you.
Madam Administrator, is there anything you wish to comment about the budget before we proceed?
No, I just want to compliment everyone on their hard work. I think we have a very good, solid budget here. So I'm looking forward to seeing the adoption.
Thank you. Mr. President, members of the Council, so what we have before us is proposed revenues, town administrator's revenues of $42,515,321. We have the budget committee's recommendation on anticipated revenues of $42,486,594. Total expenditures, the administration had predicted $42,515,121, and budget committee is projecting total expenditures of $42,486,594. So if we will, if you want to start this, if you don't mind, we have the revenue budgets broken down by all of the departments, what's going to be expected. I would like to move into, if you don't mind, expenses, Appendix C. First department is the town council. We have the administrator's proposed budget of $10,750, and we have the budget committee's proposed budget of $10,750. Any council members wish to make amendments? Changes?
May I bring something up?
Yeah.
One concern I have is maybe this can come out of contingency. Once they start renovating Kendall Dean, are we going to be assessed a feet and moving meetings elsewhere, whether it be at the school or at the middle school. I know when we had meetings there in the past, we had to pay a custodial fee, and there was a possibility of a rental fee. If that takes place for a prolonged period of time, I believe the custodial fee is in the neighborhood of $25 to $30 an hour. So on a 3-hour meeting, we're looking at $75 to $90 an hour for a custodian. And I'm not sure what the rental fee was for that, but if we're going to look at 2 meetings a month, where we could have to pay a fee, we may need money to pay for that.
Well, councilors, any comments? The other thing too is I don't know if we would be able to utilize Scarborough Hall as a place for this. This building. It's an option, I don't know. Maybe the town administrator may have some thoughts on it. Given the Scarborough Hall, its usage, I know this, it's a facility that's fairly booked. And they have the support there, the cell there.
I think it's relatively consistently utilized by the scouts. You know, we may be able to get an exception, which we have with the municipal court, and that was even impinging on their scheduling, so we try to work with them.
Just Mr. President, if I may.
Yes, thank you.
Just offer the use of the firefighters hall. It's a perfect meeting room, no extra fees included. So if you have a need, please avail yourself.
Thank you, Chief. The other piece of this, I'm sure the school committee will consider the turmoil moving around. I would hope that they wouldn't charge any boards or committees to meet at the middle school, although I can't answer for the school committee during a short period of time. So, Council, would you feel better if you just put someone in there? Or?
I just want to, we do have contingency lines. I just wanted to make it aware. Maybe I'm aware that there is a possibility that these could be associated with having moved meetings or not.
Okay. So there was basically less than a 1 point increase. This year's budget was $10,650. Both the administration as well as the budget committee has recommended $10,750. A $100 increase. Is there a motion to approve the amount of $10,750?
I make a motion to approve $10,750 under the county council line item 4 expenditures.
Motion by Councilor Nadeau. Is there a second?
Second.
Second, Councilor Soli. Roll call vote, madam.
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nadeau?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Okay. Next item is probate court. We have fiscal year 2016 approved of $8,914. We have department request of $8,100, administrative proposed $8,100, as well as the budget committee's proposed $8,100. Is there a motion to approve $8,100 to the probate court?
Motion to approve.
Motion, President Boucher. Is there a second?
Second.
Councilor Nadeau, Councilor Alves. Roll call vote, madam.
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nadeau?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Next item is the town solicitor's office. We have the assistant, we have the solicitor assistant solicitor, extraordinary litigation, legal lawyer, arbitration. So if we take them one at a time, if we look at solicitor's salary for 2016, it was approved for $58,789. We have the department request of $60,000. We have the administrator's proposal of $58,789. And then we have the budget committee's proposal of $60,000 for a 2% increase. Does anyone have any comment?
The only comment I have is that I believe we should accept the budget committee's proposal for the $60,000 figure.
Okay, I have a different comment. And then we can make a motion. We can make two motions if you wish. I was going to motion that we increase the salary to $62,000. The current town solicitor has taken on so much extraordinary litigation and has not charged us for it. I think that Solicitor Iglesias has done a stellar job in this area. So, if you just look at what was approved for extraordinary litigation 2016, $76,000, I'm rounding. And to this date, we've drawn down $27,000. I think, again, it goes without saying, Solicitor Iglesias has done a fantastic job representing us. So, Bob, if you want to make a motion to accept that 60, and then...
No, I'll make a motion to accept that 62.
Okay, I second that.
You're right.
Okay, so we have a motion, and we have a second. Madam Clerk, do you mind taking a roll call on that?
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Bushin?
Yes.
Second line item is assistant solicitor salary, currently $30,300, was requested 40 by the department. The administrator has recommended $30,300, and the budget committee has recommended $35,000. Comments? Colleagues?
Mr. Vice President, Solicitor Iglesias has taken over some duties that I would say that really were the assistant solicitor's duties. I would recommend or make a motion to accept the administrator's number of $30,300 for the assistant solicitor.
Second. Okay, we have a motion by Councilor Nato, we have a second by Councilor Sully and Alves. Discussion? Anybody?
Yes, as far as the, prosecution goes, the job he does, Stephen Shamo does for our community, is stellar. He's well respected by the police department. And although I wouldn't consider giving $35,000, I would consider giving a bump of up to $32,000.
Is that a motion?
So that would be my suggested motion.
Okay, so I would support the 32. So we're in discussion. So let the vote take place, and then we'll come back with second motion and finding.
All right, so we're voting on the motion.
On 30,000. Level funding.
Yep.
Madam?
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
No.
Mr. Bushin?
No.
Okay, motion passes 3-2. $30,000 level second funding. Extraordinary litigation, we have the department itself has asked for $57,607. The administrator has the same amount as does the budget committee. Any discussion?
Yes. I believe we should draw it back to the $76,000. Even though we hadn't used it this time, there's no guarantees that our solicitor is going to be the same solicitor for the next council. So given that facet, I believe that we should have the $76,000 versus almost $20,000 less. There's no guarantees what the next council is going to choose. I know we're going to have the same sort of situation that we've had in this community.
So your motion would be what?
To keep it at $76,000, the current level, $76,425.
There's a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilor Alves. Madam Clerk, do you want to take a roll call, please?
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
No.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Bushin?
Yes.
Lawyer arbitration is the next line. This year was $30,000. We have recommendation of the department itself, administration, and budget committee for $30,000. Any discussion?
Looking at just looking at past years, it was $25,000, and I guess 2015 was $51,000. probably ask to maybe bump it up an extra $10,000.
Is that a motion?
It's a motion to...
Okay, there's a motion on the floor to increase lawyer arbitration, labor lawyer arbitration to $40,000. Is there a second? Is there a second? Everything else, the motion dies. $30,000 is what has been recommended. Is there a motion to approve $30,000 for a lawyer arbitration?
Motion to approve $30,000 for labor lawyer arbitration.
Motion by Councilor Nail, is that seconded by Councilor Sullivan? Councilor Sullivan?
No, I'm making a motion.
Oh, so we have a different motion?
Different
motion, okay, so right now let's take the first motion, it's $30,000, is there a second? I will second for a vote. Madam Clerk, would you do a roll call, please?
Ms. House? No. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
No.
Mr. Zaleski?
No.
Mr. Bushet?
No.
Okay, now is there a motion for labor lawyer arbitration, the amount?
I'd like to make a motion for $18,000.
There's a motion for labor lawyer arbitration of $18,000 by Councilor House. Is there a second?
Second for discussion.
Second for discussion. Discuss.
Thank you. Councilor House, where did you come up with the number of $18,000?
Because we only used $15,800 so far this year. So I'm just doing a little bit of an increase in the amount of $18,000. I think we need 30.
Okay. What happens if we go over contingency?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah.
So, motion, we have a second in the amount of $18,000. Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Ms. House?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Bushet?
No.
Motion carries 4-1. Next department is municipal court. The total amount is $35,297. Do any of the council members have any dialogue they wish to enter into?
Excuse me, Mr. Vice President?
Yes.
Can you do a total for the council's department?
It's right there, Ken.
Yeah, Jason, your total amount?
$186,725.
What is it?
$186,725.
Jason, I would just like to ask the solicitors of roughly $4,000. Is the budget committee also for redundancy and double check that someone had these numbers as well? Yes? Someone in the budget committee so we can compare, just make sure. So the next department is municipal court judge. We have the department itself asking for $36,630. The town administrator, as well as the budget committee, recommended $35,297. Discussion?
Mr. Vice President, I just have a clerk salary. It's going up from 12.6 to department recommendation $15,904, and the department and budget committee and administrator of 14601. I would like to bring that down to 3%. I don't know what that comes up to. Jason, can I do that?
Sure. The increase of 3% would be 378.03. So if you wait 1 second, I'll give you that total figure. It's 12,979. You see the number at
3%. 12,979?
Yep.
You said decrease, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for a 3%.
Yeah, it's currently, it's posted as recommended 15.87 increase, and with a 3% is 12,979. Is that a motion, Council?
That's a motion.
Is a motion? Do we have a second?
Second.
Second by President Bouchet. Madam Clerk?
Ms. House?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
No.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Bouchet?
Yes.
Are there any other line items in the municipal court? Okay, hearing none, then, as presented by the, you can see that the town administrator and the budget committee pretty much mirror each other on this, so the remaining numbers, I'm going to vote to approve them. Madam Clerk, can we have a motion to approve the rest of the warrant as presented?
Get a dollar figure on that, Jason?
It's $33,675.
Motion to approve $33,675 for municipal court. All line items remaining the same, except the clerk salary given a 3% increase.
Motion by Council Nadel, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Council Sullivan, Council Boucher. Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nadel?
Yes.
Mr. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Next department is administrator's office. We have current south. Well, is there any edits? Instead of going through them one by one, is there any edits the council would like to discuss?
Mr. Vice President?
Councilor?
Administrative salary, I'd like to stick with the department request and the administrative request of leveling that at the $75,000.
That's a motion, Councilor?
Motion.
Motion by Councilor Alves, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Council Boucher, Council Soli. Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Ms. Alves, yes. Mrs. Nadel?
No.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Are there any other items in the administrator's office that someone would wish to discuss?
I'd like to make a motion for the admin assistant to bring that in line with 3% also.
Is that a motion, Council?
That's a motion.
Is there a second?
Second. I'm just trying to figure out.
That would be 32,000.
How would figure?
That would be a decrease. She's getting 4% now. It would be a decrease. 1%
Well, it's not a decrease. She's still getting an increase in salary.
Well, no, right.
Decrease
sorry,
in percentage,
decrease
right?
Decrease in proposed.
Jason, 32,900. I'm sorry, I'm doing your job.
Give me 2 seconds to just do this addition, and I will let you know what it is. That would be 31,673.
31. Correct, because I was taking it off the projector. Yes. That's why you are the finance director.
That's why I put the spreadsheet up there, so everybody can see it.
Okay, so the motion, again, is for how much? 31? I can't see it.
31,673.
Okay, there's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. Madam Clerk?
Ms. Alves? Yes. Mrs. Nadel?
No.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-1. Any other line items?
Yes. Go ahead, Councilor Soli.
On the audiovisual, just more of a statement, how come we're paying for the school department's meetings?
I had that, I was going to question that myself.
I had no problem funding. I believe the last meeting talked about $125 per meeting.
Mm-hmm.
I had no problem funding $125 per meeting for the town council meetings to come out of the town council budget. And for the school committee, they can pull a line item out of their budget to fund for some of their meetings.
Based on, if we were to have, and we have more of them, if we were to have two a month, and we rounded it to instead of 24 meetings, we rounded it to 30 meetings, would it be $3,750?
Yeah.
You've done that? Does that make sense? Is that a motion, Council?
Yes.
Solid?
Yes.
Discussion.
Okay, let's discuss.
The other item, too, is the fact that I can understand Councilman Sully's issue with this, but at the same time, too, is that, you know, before when the school committee meetings weren't broadcast, and of course we were all left in the dark as to what was happening, I would rather spend the extra $3,000 to know what our counterparts on the school committee are doing. The town residents, I'm sure, would want to know as well. So that we can have a fostering, very nice workable relationship with them as well. So I would propose to pay the money for having the meetings photographed.
School committee member Lombardi's going, yeah, pay for it.
Yeah.
What do you think, committee member? Do you think the school committee would pick up their share of the award?
We're looking to the town council for open transparency. So if you were paying for it, that would be open transparent. And then...
I think he works in Providence.
I don't think it matters either way. But I would appreciate it if paid for it just for consistency.
So, Councilor, so if you take 30 meetings at 125, I believe it came to $3,750.
Yes.
Is that correct, Councilor Rouse? Yeah. Would that be a motion?
Yes.
All right, there's a motion by Councilor Sully to approve $3,750 for the videographer for the town council.
Only town council?
Yes.
Yes.
Not if we have to include the school department?
Well, that's the motion.
Okay, just wanted to share a little bit.
Second.
Second by Councilor Rouse. Madam Clerk?
Ms. Alves, yes. Mrs. Nato?
Nope.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
No.
Okay, motion carries 3-2. Any other line items in the administrator's office? I have one. We have the grant writer position where it's been funded $2,000. It hasn't been drawn down since 2015 into this date, 2016. Probably because I'm going to assume that $2,000 is a pittance, and I don't know how you're going to get somebody to write a grant for $2,000. Grants are extremely important. Mr. Erickson's been writing grants, he's been helping us out, but he should be focusing on comprehensive planning and reviewing of, and we do appreciate him writing grants. I'd like to make a motion that we increase the grant writer from $2,000 to $5,000. It will pay itself off.
Second.
We have a motion by the second.
The discussion.
Discussion? Sure.
It's a motion by my concern is that I believe in performance-driven results. And when you have somebody who goes out and writes grants for you, and you provide compensation at 10%, believe me, they'll turn every stone for the community. And we can spend $5,000. I haven't spent $2,000. But the fact is that if you want real money, you have to have somebody who's willing to go for it.
I would agree with you. Sometimes the administrative fees are tied into that as well. For people doing quarterly reports and reports about the grants.
I mean, that's where I'm coming from. I mean, you look at when the council hired Mr. Nash. Julian Nash.
Yep.
And he gave us a grant of $350,000, money that we would have probably never had. And of course, it's $35,000 or 10% off of that grant. But we got $315,000, which we'll use for energy projects in our community. We'll benefit the taxpayers in the long run. I guess that's performance driven. Whether people are running, I know we have some fine people in town. I know we have Peter Branconia, and he's got many grants for our community. And if you want to take on other duties on behalf of the town, whatever. But the idea is that if you have somebody, a grant writer, who can look through the information that's out there and get paid for every grant that they get, you know, to me, local compensation is unnecessary because it's all about the more they get, the more we make. And it's a win-win situation.
I agree with performance base, but you know, we may have some small things like parks and rec grants out there. And
it was just a couple meetings ago where Mr. Erickson came before us asking for up to $5,000 for a grant writer, possibly the land purchase. So I wouldn't be opposed to funding that line item, because you're right. I mean, you don't know what's going to come down the pipe for grants. I mean, we can fund it at 5, we can fund it at 50. I mean, depending on how many grants you pull, depending on how much payback you get from the community. But again, it was very recently that Mr. Erickson stood in front of us asking for $5,000 for a grant writer. So I would be okay with the number of $5,000.
Okay, so any further discussion? We've got a motion, we've got a second to increase the grant writings from $2,000 to $5,000.
Going on discussion to sort of echo what President Boucher said, it is performance driven. I do believe, and it's hard to earmark something that's a percentage, but I do believe that it should be written as a percentage rather than a specific dollar amount. If they do 25 grants, it's still only going to get $2,000 or $5,000, and that's not per grant, right?
A perfect example would be the small playground grants. I know that one and two, Ms. Erickson wrote one, Mr. Pendergast wrote one. I don't know how complicated they are, but you put it about staff members to write them, certainly goes a long way. But I think what you do is you start with $5,000 and get the appealing. If someone steps forward, we could start the developers. The next council could say, you know what, we've had great results. And I like what Mr. Fuchsia said about Julian Dash, did a phenomenal job for us, but he was set up with a 10%, he came in contractually, there was an obligation there. And that's paid for itself over and over. So I just think $5,000, it could be somebody in the town that's retired or looking for a little job at $5,000 to start writing grants for us, that'd be great. No, and if they write two or three, yeah, perfect.
One last after discussion?
Yeah.
Or unless you want to go with a full-time grant writer for the town?
I'm not into creating a position myself.
What I'm just saying is that you want somebody to devote time for grants and whatnot.
Well, can you imagine if someone started this? Oh, look, I'm trying to be proactive. If somebody took this on for $5,000 and wrote a grant for us for $100,000, you take a look at that person and say, you know, maybe we make you part-time next year, and write three or four more grants, and then they do that, and you look at a full-time performance base. You're doing good. So, going to call a vote. Madam Secretary, do you mind?
Sal? Yes.
We're voting on $5,000?
$5,000.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Fuchsia?
Yes.
Jason, do you have a total now? Are there any other line items?
Current total is $121,998.
Thank you. Okay, next department is the town clerk's office.
Well, Mr. President, I think you need to make a motion on that amount.
$5,000?
No, the total amount of the
motion to approve the administrative office line item of $121,998.
Second. Town clerk?
Yes. Mrs.
Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr.
Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Fuchsia?
Yes.
Thank you, Solicitor. So we take motions on the last one. When we made changes to municipal court, did we take a motion to approve that amount as well?
I was just asking.
I don't think we did.
Yes, you did.
We did?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. All right, the next office is the town clerk's office. Town clerk's office, councilors. Any comments? That's the town clerk's office. Currently, we have the amount of department request of $138,460, same by the administration and the same by the budget members. Thank you, make a suggestion there. Currently, the town clerk has paid $59,021 a year. There's a town administrator, the department asked for $60,792. The administrator said the same amount, as well as the budget committee. I would just like to reflect back on the 30 years that the town clerk has served this town, not just as a town clerk, but also probate court clerk as well. She does double duty. Can't think I've ever heard a complaint about the town clerk's office or probate court. With that in mind, I would like to take and suggest that the town clerk's salary be elevated to $62,562. That's a 6% increase.
Okay.
There's a motion, there's a second. Discussion? Madam Clerk, will you take a roll call vote, please?
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zaleski?
Yes.
Boucher?
Yes.
Are there any other departments, any other line items in the town clerk's office? Anybody wishes to discuss? Hearing none, Jason, can you give us a revised total?
The new total with the change is $140,230.
Is there a motion to approve $140,230 for town clerk's office?
Motion to approve.
Motion to approve, Mr. Boucher, Ms. Al. Sir, can you consider one of those a second? Ms. Al, is that a second?
Yes.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second. Roll call vote.
Ms. Al? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mrs. Walensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Next department is the planning department. The amount 2016 is $129,143. We have the department request, am I reading this right? Glasses, 121,686. Administrator's proposal, 121,686. I can't see. They're all the same. Thank you. Any discussion on the planning division? Is there a motion to approve the amount of $121,686 for planning division?
Motion to approve.
Motion to approve by Councilor Boucher, seconded by Councilor Soli. Madam Clerk.
Ms. Al? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Walensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Next on the agenda is Board of Canvassers. This year there were appropriated $19,975. The department asked for $15,550. The administrator echoed the $15,550, as did the budget committee. Is there any discussion on the Board of Canvassers?
Are there any changes from the state that have been sent out to you as of yet? Okay, they did send you equipment?
Not yet. They're planning to.
And will your budget require training for these people on your new equipment?
Their expense, yeah.
Is there nothing in this budget to cover the primaries and the general election?
Thank you, Madam Clerk.
I'll make a motion to approve the Board of Canvassers at the $15,550.
Motion, is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilor Ralph. Madam Clerk?
Ms. Alves? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Walensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Next department is the finance department. Currently it is funded at $200,687. The department has requested $213,931. The administrator has echoed that amount, and the budget committee has recommended $216,149. Councilors, any discussion regarding any one of those lines?
Yes, the finance director.
Councilor?
I believe that the stellar performance of our current finance director would warrant to be competitive with other salaries that are paid to others, because we rank near the bottom as far as salaries and finance directors. Also the fact is that some of the things that this current finance director, one simple thing, moving our checking account to another bank that saves us $25,000 in fees alone, plus other services which we'd be able to get, I believe it was called a lockbox, which is phenomenal, because I'm not sure exactly what that is worth on itself, but it has to be worth several thousand dollars. I don't know if you have a figure for that, Mr. Pomeroy?
It's really a productivity thing. Taxpayers, rather than paying to our collection department, they will be paying to a bank processing center that costs us nothing. So it alleviates time and effort in the department, which ultimately we can focus more on things such as cleaning up properties on the roll that haven't been there for tax sale, focusing our efforts in other collection efforts, as well as reminders on delinquencies, making it formal policy rather than just haphazard when we have time to do it. So it's really more about efficiency and productivity than it is anything else.
But also during our period of time, all the policies that he has written and updated, as well as the monetary savings, even doing a little bit of investment for the town,
which is generated in a short period of time, $30,000. So, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, is that these are things that no other finance director has done. He's generating money, but I prefer to go with the recommendation of the budget committee for that particular salary. I believe that's
$85,000. Yep.
Is that a motion?
Yes, it is.
Second for discussion.
Motion by Councilor Bushnell, second by Councilor Nado for discussion.
I would like to echo Councilor Boucher's statement and add some of my own. Over the time that Mr. Conley has been here, he has saved this town over and beyond the salary that we are proposing for him. He continues to look for the best way to do the work that he does in this town, and he does a lot more than just finance director. He is IT director. What else are you, Jason? What else do you do?
It's all in the charter.
You do a lot for this town. You've kept our financial rating very high, which has done tremendous things for our bonds. Refinancing the bonds and the bonds that we have coming onto the books now. You've done an absolutely phenomenal job. And I would go over and beyond the $85,000 if I could. But I absolutely, unequivocally support the 15.79% increase for the finance director. Let's start bringing our people in line and stop becoming a training ground for other communities to benefit from our experiences.
Council?
I am.
I think Jason's done a great job, but as well, I also think all of our department heads with the limited resources they've had have done an exceptional job. I agree, the finance director is severely underpaid. I also agree that the town clerk's office is underpaid, the public works director is underpaid, the finance director, the tax assessor's office is underpaid. The fact of the matter is you can't solve it all with one fell swoop. Not one department. I don't have a problem with giving an increase in what I feel is an equitable increase, but I don't think that you solve it all at once, one time. Not for one department, anyway.
Further discussion?
Yes.
Yeah, I have further discussion. Jason, I just want to say you've done a great job, but I can't support the 15.79%. That would be, you'd be paid higher than the town administrator, and just, like Councilor Soli said, every other department head does a great job too. And there will be plenty of funds in contingency should, when a new administrator comes in and they make their own assessments and they decide that after a period of time, individuals should get merit increases, that should be something that can come back to the council. But at this time, I really could not support 15.79%. Like I said, you've done a great job.
I would like to add one more point if Councilor Alves is done. Mr. Parmley's first year, he received 0%. The second year, he received 1%. His third year, he received 1%. If we gave him 3% increase over that time, it would have compounded to about this number that Mr. Boucher and I are both recommending.
Jason,
as well as the budget committee.
Across three fiscal years, if FY17 is accounted for.
And you started, what, in January of 15, 1 year? And
yep.
You got a proration or nothing?
There was no raise for the finance director for the 14-15 year.
And
so
then last year, you got the increase, right?
A proration of 1.25, I believe. So 0% for 1 year, 1.25 for the second.
But you weren't here the full year.
Correct. Position went without that.
Councilor Alves, you raised the
question.
We have to
look back to what had happened in this town. We've had five or six finance directors within probably 8 years, which gave us much fiscal instability. We've also had issues down in the tax assessor's office. Both Mr. Dolce and Mr. Conway have basically taken this town and brought back the stability we needed. They also put in the checks and balances that we needed. And the fact is that, you know, if we continue losing people, and I learned one lesson, is that the assessor's office and the finance director's office are the pillars of the fiscal strength of this town. Because if you don't get the numbers right in the assessment, and never get the numbers right in the finance department, and after going through with one finance director every time, every meeting, the numbers never added up. I'm sorry, but you know, you pay for what you get. You pay small bananas, you get chimps. And at this point in time, that's why, like I said, I believe he's more than earned his money. And like I said, I know there's other projects I'd like to see. He's been giving me a great insight, especially when it came to the solar lighting for the town, and ways that we could probably save hundreds of thousands of dollars in a short period of time if we play it right. So, I mean, these are all things that he does more than a regular finance director by far. And the results are that our bond rating is what it is, including all the debt we've incurred. And he's kept this ship afloat.
We have a motion and second to increase the finance director's salary to $85,000. Madam Clerk, would you take a roll call vote, please?
Ms. Al? No. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
No.
Mr. Zielinski?
No.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Okay, motion fails 3-2. Is there another motion regarding the finance director's salary?
I'll make a motion to propose the finance director's salary at $80,000 for fiscal year 17.
Second for discussion.
Okay, there was a motion, there's a second. Discuss, please.
I think we need to start bringing people in line with the salaries. And again, I think the finance director is doing an amazing job, and while I don't support a 16% increase, by going up to 80, it takes into account where he's sitting today, his recommendation, the administrator's recommendation, and the budget committee's recommendation. It's shy of 10%, and it gets him in the door. We were just talking earlier in the meeting about, you know, doing this study and everything else. You know, I have no problem making a good faith effort and giving $80,000, and then where those numbers fall in the future is where those numbers fall in the future.
Any other discussion?
Yes. I noticed the town administrator had also proposed $82,215. And also the preliminary department report was the same. Is that I would like to see it go to that figure, 82,215, if it's possible, which would be an 8.8% increase.
No, that'd be 12%.
Oh, I'm sorry, I looked at one column.
8 would be roughly 8%.
Right. Okay, I'm sorry, my apologies.
So I want to weigh in this, Jason. You've done a phenomenal job. Call you up, get the answers. We've heard people say we can't correct it overnight, but I think we've got a good start here with Council Soli at 9%, because next year if you choose to stay here, and you get another 9%, you'd be at 87,000. And I don't know the composition of the town council, but
You've
done a great job. Super job. I told you that in person, and I've said it here a number of times.
Thank you.
But it's just a wave of magic wand. You know, we give the public works director 18%, because you know what, the roads have to get plowed so everybody can get to school and get to work too. So Okay, so we've got a motion, do we have a second?
We have two motions.
Okay, which motion do we have?
Mrs. Soli, is it 80, mine is 82?
Second.
Who did the first motion?
This is for discussion.
8,000, Mr. Soli, second, we have a second.
Was it second?
Yes. So we've got a motion, we've got a second for $8,000, correct?
Just want to say one last thing.
Sure.
Continue.
Yep.
I know as far as finances go, Mr. Lombardi is the city treasurer of Providence. I know he's well qualified, but for $80,000, what would we get? Mr. Lombardi, your professional opinion. No, but I mean, the fact is that.
I'm going to call the roll. This is for $80,000.
Ms. Els? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
No.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zalansky?
Yes.
Mr. Bujay?
No.
Motion passes 3-2. Are there any other line items within the finance department? You know, Jason, I want to go back next year. I don't see 9% being another high bump for you next year. If you hit.
The problem is, Mr. Vice President, he's told that every year. So not only do I feel like we've slighted Mr. Parmalee, we've also slighted our budget committee by not going with their recommendation. We've just done this town a disservice.
Council Nato, this is going into my 12th year sitting up here approving budgets. I have never seen a 9% increase in payroll. I've seen it 3.
Yeah, but he didn't get 3. He got 0.1.
So we're at 9%.
And that's what passed. I mean, I can't argue the point anymore.
Okay. Ready to move on? I mean, if you wish to have more dialogue, I will.
I do.
Okay.
I think Mr. Parmalee should be able to speak for himself if he has something that he would like to add that maybe you didn't.
I will limit this to town council member discussion. Council, if you wish to discuss, absolutely.
The only thing I can say is about when you're dealing with financial professionals is that those individuals who do more than their job, I believe, as in the private sector, should be compensated as such. All the things that Jason has done for this town, some are by charter, others are extraordinary. If he was a lawyer, I guess it would be a lot of extraordinary costs that would be associated with what he would be paid. I know our solicitor has done this town a wonderful benefit of covering some of these costs and hasn't charged the town. But you're looking, anyway, it's the fact is that it's the individual, the professionalism that Jason brings to the table. And again, I don't want to relive the times when we're getting financial reports and numbers don't even add up, and which led us into getting the budget committee, the first was the Nicholson report that wasn't finished, and then Mr. Lombardi finished that report.
But, you know, Councilor, you had on the agenda, you had item number 6, the product efficiency study. I think if we get that to happen, in the next sitting council with contingency funds, once we have the productivity, I'm sure that whoever that council is can take that contingency, and if they feel it merits a pay increase for staff members, they can do that. The door's not closed, though. There's options.
No, I'm just saying, but the also too is that I don't think there's no line up even for, let's say, education. Let's say he decides to take extra courses to help with municipal accounting or whatnot. I mean, these are all things that we should also consider into the budget of that office.
Well, maybe it should be put in the budget. Okay, so.
Was that 765?
Do you want to increase that?
Absolutely.
The department's recommendation was 800. Is that sufficient for the classes that you or your assistant would like to take or anybody else within the finance department?
The only thing that's in here this year would be GFOA membership for myself, because currently none of our staff members are GFOA members. Town isn't either, so this is our membership fee, which includes me as our representative to it.
Does that come out of dues, though, or does that come out of your...
It's budgeted on education here. Okay. I mean, it could come out of dues, it's the same thing, ultimately, but I threw it in education, because for me, it's access to their site. I get quarterly updates with, for example, last year, the pension reform that touched our financial statements, all the research I did on my own, they would send me, you know, nice packaged updates to tell me, hey, this is what you want to be abreast of. So it's, you know, it's educationally related in my mind.
Okay. I would like to make a motion to increase the educational line item to double the fiscal year 2016 to $1,600 for classes.
Second. Discussion. Second for discussion. All right. Even education, but if we go back to 2014, 2015, none of it was spent. We spent to date, coming into the end of May, 180 out of 800. Now, I don't know if it's convoluted. I think Council solely asked if it was partially the dues. I don't know that. But I would certainly support Jason or as any member of his department going for education. I mean, it would be a fool not to do that. Jason, what do you think would be a fair amount?
It depends on what kind of classes you're looking at. I mean, if I'll just throw out an example for everybody. If I were to look at like a CGFM, like a Certified Government Financial Manager, it would probably be an addition of another 1,000 on top of this to go for something like that. But is that me furthering myself, or is, you know what I mean? I don't really know what line that is, so
I, would like to
I don't think it was ever put in
for that. Withdraw
my second.
Okay, withdrawn, second has withdrawn. Motion.
I just want to put before the motion, I just have one question, Jason. Jason, as far as seminars goes for governmental accounting and the like, I'm not sure if they're offered in the area very often or not, or is it somewhere that has to be, one would have to travel to get there?
Travel.
It depends on if I'm attending a seminar or if I'm taking online continuing education. You can do online classes. Going to the seminar, though, you get a lot more bang for your buck out of it, where you learn a lot more, it's hands-on. So ultimately, I guess the travel side of it's more costly, but it's more beneficial.
Do we reimburse you for your travel?
For these types of things, yes. These have been reimbursed to employees in the past.
Is that figure of...
Would be in that travel and dues.
Is the 440 acceptable for that?
Well, I've never put in for mileage, and I've driven my car probably 500-600 miles. So I don't know. You're not going to see this line item used by me, but you'll see it by other employees that use their personal vehicles. So.
Just one last question is that if you were to go, say, to one of these seminars, what do they? Any idea what they range from? They're about $3,000, $3,500. I mean, it's going to be.
I don't think it's nearly. Even remotely close to that. I think you'd be looking at my registration fee of a few hundred and then traveling costs for me to be there.
Oh, well, it's okay if you had a plane or something, let's say the West Coast or somewhere else.
I don't know. I've actually never researched this kind of travel for this kind of thing because I didn't even assume the discussion would happen. So.
Mr. Parmley. Would $2,000 for the educational line item and then bringing up travel and dues to $1,000 so you could attend seminars that wouldn't be in, maybe in California we covered plane fare and hotel.
I wouldn't say I wouldn't appreciate the offer and that I would like to take advantage of it, but I'm not going to say I'm requesting that or anything.
Right, but it helps you in your
absolutely.
Profession.
Absolutely.
And with obviously taking financial government classes helps the town.
Correct.
So that's, I'll do it in two separate motions. I would like to increase the educational.
It's early.
But I know. The educational line item. From the requested 765 to 2,000 under the finance department.
There's a motion to increase it from 800 to 2,000. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilor Bouchette. Madam Clerk, please call the vote.
Ms. House? Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Bushet?
Yes.
I would like to make a motion to increase traveling dues under the same item in the finance department from 105, which is the 2016 fiscal year. The proposed 440, I would like to increase that to 1,000.
Second. The motion and second. Madam Clerk, call the vote, please.
Ms. Alves? Mrs. Nada?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
No.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Bushet?
Yes.
Okay, Jason, we have a new total?
With those two changes in
three
the... three changes. It is 212,944.
Is there a motion to approve $212,944 for the finance department?
So moved.
Second, Madam Chair. Second, I'm sorry.
So we have a motion to approve $212,944 and second. Madam Clerk?
Ms. Alves? Mrs. Nada?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr.
Yes.
Mr. Bushet?
Yes.
Next department's tax assessor is department. Colleagues, any comments?
We had a couple items. Tax assessors. Salary of the assessor's office, is that the promotion of the assessor's salary is $60,450.
It's a motion by Councilman Bouchet, the salary of $60,450. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Councilman Nada. Discussion? Madam Clerk, roll call vote, please. Is there a discussion? Sorry. Council?
I just want to say that I can't justify the 9% because we only gave Jason 9%. So I would be looking to go at like 5% for the tax assessor.
I was going to say the same, to stay consistent with trying to get everyone in line.
Gradually
increase, not just, again, throw the highest number at every department.
So there is a motion, and there was a second. I'm going to call the vote.
This was for discussion. Remember that?
Yeah.
Further discussion. If you look at the overall duties, what Mr. Dolce has done in his tenure here as our tax assessor. He took over records that were in a shambles. He dutifully went through them and brought everything up to snuff in a relatively short period of time. And the fact is that, again, the assessment is not right. The finances of this town will not be right. In fact, if he did not get a raise from the time he was here, and I think the second year was about two, I think,
in year two.
But the fact is that with the changing items from the state, and also you can install checks and balances for the abatements that were sorely lacking. So this way, if there's an abatement that's going to be done, everybody has to sign off the council votes, and whoever installs that in the computer, they also has to sign off on it as well as the individual who put it in the computers. So he's put in great checks and balances, which has served this town well. And I believe that, you know, he's worth every penny of what he's done. But I'd like to defer to Mr. Dolce to enlighten this community on what he's done for us.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. President. I'm really here to defend my the second item on my department budget. I have a level budget this year. I'd just like to thank, good evening, Mr. President, Town Council, and thank you to the Budget Committee for their help. I didn't recommend any raise. It's certainly the recommendation of the Budget Committee. I can only tell you what I've done, and Jake, one of our efforts has been to go to a performance-based, more of a performance-based, I think we should go to performance-based. But I've set goals every year, I've met my goals, a couple of things that I've instituted. Not only did I do a 7-page report to identify what the town experienced with their financial difficulties, but I instituted policies and procedures that correct that. One of those things was real-time abatements. The town of North Smithfield, historically, going back 5 years, has written off over $100,000 a year. My goal last year was to limit that to $50,000 to $60,000. I believe I was at approximately $55,000. This year, my goal was to get it below $50,000, which I believe is doable. That's going to help the town put, will help the town get on a stable financial basis, which is very important. Again, I'm not here to, I'll just tell you what I did, and then you can take it for whatever it's worth. I've set goals, I've set 7 goals for this year. I've submitted to the town administrator and finance director, and I'm hoping to accomplish those. I don't know if I can answer any questions you have.
This is the also to you. It's the next item I have to will be the need to upgrade from a clerk to a deputy tax assessor. And the idea is that you are, and I realize you are a 2-man department for the most part.
Yeah, 2-person department.
Okay.
But yeah, fact, you're. Excuse me.
But the fact is that person, if he or she would move up to deputy tax assessor, they would have to have the same certifications as you, am I correct?
No, it's similar to what I have as a certified assessor, or I'm an assessor. It's a certified tax professional. Requires 80 hours of classroom with a test, approximately 4 classes, and she's taken half of those classes. I just like to say, with one of my concerns, I'm not here to get my clerk a raise or to get her a better position. I'm here to hopefully convince the town that this position is needed for this office. It's a $1.6 billion base. We raised $32 million in taxes. Well, this year we're projected to levy 33 plus million. It's a very important office. It's a very technical office because there's interest in real estate being transferred along with Rhode Island laws having to be followed. And for a 2-person office, the work has to be spread out. One of the things I've tried to do, and it's worked very well in my career, is to build redundancy into the system. So any work that I do is reviewed by the other person in my office. Any work that the other person does is reviewed by me. It's the only way you can run an office of this size with 2 people and ensure that the numbers at the end of the day, which is the certification, come out accurate, and you really limit your level of errors. Because you do have errors. I mean, we're just trying to manage the errors down to a very manageable position, which again I would say is less than, right around 30 to 40,000 a year, per year in tax write-offs. So again, it's a position, upgrading this position with these requirements would do that. Now, it's similar to what the planner did in the planning department. And that's where I followed pretty much the same procedure that he did. I went to the administration, I went to the personnel board with the rewritten job descriptions. I presented those to the budget committee, and I presented them to the union. And tonight, I'm here asking for your consideration. And again, I think it's needed for this office. So I'll just leave it at that. And if you have any other questions, I'd be happy to address them.
We've had a motion and a second to approve $60,450 for the assessor salary. Madam Clerk, call the vote, please.
Ms. Alves?
No.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
No.
Mr. Zalinski?
No.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Okay, motion fails 3-2. Is there another motion regarding the tax assessor's salary?
I'd like to make a motion for 5% increase.
I'll second that. So a motion and a second. Any discussion? 5% increase should bring it to $58,232.
Just out of curiosity, why 5%? Is it is there a reason for 5%, or is it just out of compromise?
Okay, we have a motion. Any further dialogue? Okay, the motion. A second. Madam Clerk, will you call the vote, please?
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Okay, motion passes unanimously.
So that's how we would split the figure at 58,000?
$58,232. 5%. Can you follow up, Jason? I can't see.
Oh, 58232 is correct.
58232. Okay, is there a motion to approve the tax assessor's budget for 2017 in the amount of 58,000?
Do you have another question?
What's the amount? The total amount for the department? Oh, I'm sorry.
Do you have a question?
Okay, are there any other line items?
Yes, well, it's dealing with the. He wants to change it from a clerk to a deputy tax assessor position. However, I don't know what the salary is. That something that the union's going to have to agree upon, or the question is, can this be a non-union position?
No, I believe the union will have to agree to that. We've met with them. But I did want to add, regarding the steps, there's two steps, and when I spoke with everyone, I told them that, if they want to hire a deputy without the certification, they can certainly do that, and they have the flexibility to offer a lower salary. But I think if someone demonstrates the ability and the desire to get the training, and again, bring the skills to this office that I feel like needs. I see no reason for having two steps. What we've recommended is, since she's completed half of the courses successfully, then she'd go the first step, which is represented in the budget, and then there'd be a second step after that when she gets certification.
So the first step would be 37,000 for fiscal years 16 and 17?
That's correct.
And 17, 18 would be 41,000?
Yes.
With the certification?
That would be a level B. A level D test for a tax assessor, for an appraiser license.
It's through the International Association of Assessing Offices.
Oh, okay. Do you hold a real estate appraiser license? Just out of curiosity.
I'm a certified Rhode Island assessor, and I'm also a Rhode Island certified general appraiser.
Awesome. Thank you.
Just to let you know, if I could add this, she's taken the Rhode Island administration course, which is 3 days. She's taken the IAAO 717 Standards of Professional Practice and Ethics, and she's taken course 201, which is the appraisal of land. That's approximately 2 weeks. The next class will be Fundamentals of Real Estate Property Appraisal, and then Income Approach Evaluation would be the two remaining classes.
But then she'd have to take state certifications?
Then she would receive this certification, tax profession in Rhode Island.
So I'd like to make a motion that we create a two-step tier, and then I guess probably it's under clerk salary.
You can't. You're going to be going to the next budget year. How can you make the motion for this year?
I'd like to make a motion for this year, too. Okay. To leave it, but give it upon certification,
That's the whole thing. We were looking at...
I'm going to see what the next council does with the budget.
Mr. Solicitor, is there a way, because this is creation of a new position as deputy tax assessor?
I don't see that.
Is it possible?
I'm not seeing that in the budget, but...
No, I'm just saying it.
I have a question, Mr. Fulton. We have a clerk salary proposed at 37, it's currently 32, and then assistant assessor line is blank. This is in addition?
That's on me. The line was linked to the clerk and not linked to the assistant assessor. So it should be on the assistant assessor line.
Okay, so...
I can fix it right now if you'd like.
Not the...
So the clerk's salary line should be down on the assistant solicitor's salary line?
Correct, and the clerk should go away if that is what's... It should just be moved along.
So will that still be a union position?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you, Council.
I was asking if it would be a union position.
It's still a union position?
Well, yeah, we have the job description, proposed job description changes that have been pretty much approved by everyone. Again, I don't know about the union, but I know they're aware of it and they're waiting for a decision. I mean, if it's not acted on, then I guess they don't have to make a decision, but if it is acted on, then they will, you know, they will make a decision on it, is my understanding. That's reasonable, right?
Wouldn't the union have to go through negotiations?
Mr. President, I'm sorry.
Wouldn't the union have to go through negotiations on the salary piece? Just like any other contract would be? Like, if there's a contract already in place, well, anybody, if there's a contract already in place, how do we change a bid contract?
There's no contract.
You don't have a union contract?
Well, the union contract, but they've already approved the position and the increase in salary contingent upon approval from the council. If there's no approval from the council, it just goes back to clerk.
Mr. President, just a point of order from what I'm hearing from the finance director. I think technically the council's motion would be to defund the clerk's salary and fund the assistant assessor's salary. That would be the motion if you're going to do this. And then next year is next year, with whether or not that assistant solicitor assessor becomes certified and makes another representation for salary. But I think it's about your motion should be focused on, if you're doing this, it's defunding the clerk position to zero and funding the assistant assessor's position to that number. I think that's what's happening here.
Isn't that what's happening, Mr. Dolce?
Sounds
fine to me. Well, isn't that what you just testified to? That you're creating an assistant assessor's position? Well, that's what they should be acting.
It's a union position, correct? Right. Union will retain a member, no members are being... Yeah. Okay. So, if you have a motion to move on, okay, well, I guess we have to... Once you retract your motion, make a motion to define clerk salary. Let's square it away. So, what are the main motions?
Retract your motion, then I'll do it.
Retract my motion as on the
clerk salary. Second, you retract your motion.
Yes,
okay. Main major and second has retracted their motion on clerk salary. Now we're looking for a motion to defund that clerk salary amount. And we'll take two separate motions, okay? So there's a motion to defund the clerk salary amount. Is there a motion?
So moved at $32,136.
Second.
We have a motion and a second.
Mr. President, again, this is as proposed by the Budget Committee. They're proposing $37,000 for the clerk.
Right.
So it should be a motion to defund the clerk's salary of $37,000 as proposed by the Budget Committee. That's what the motion should be, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I did it as the fiscal year 2017, so.
But on the era, the current, if you want to include, currently funded at 32,000, 36, proposed, then I would go with that, but 37, it's not covered at all.
Okay, so I would like to amend the motion to cover defunding the clerk salary of the current fiscal year 2016 of $32,136,000 and, $32,136, and the proposed by the Department Review Administrator and Budget Committee, $37,000.
Second. John, motion, we have a second to defund the clerk salary, and this will follow through for the rest of this budget here. So, just defund, there's a motion and a second. Madam Clerk, do my call the vote, please.
Ms. Alves? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zmielewski?
Yes.
Mr. Bushet?
Yes.
Now, make the motion for success. Well, basically, Councilor Nato's asking, the next step on this should be to make a motion to fund the assistant assessor in the amount which previous this year's salary was. Just read it off, just take those numbers and drop them down. $32,136 with a proposed $37,000 from the department, from the administrator, and from the budget committee.
So moved.
Oh, thanks.
Discussion.
Discussion. There's a motion, and do you second for discussion?
Yeah.
Second by Council Sullivan.
You just told local department heads they don't do 15% raises. That's a 15.14% increase.
That's a motion to increase. Now,
right.
Remember, I wanted to make sure we were not losing the union position. I need to hear that. So the union position is going to say it's just going to be titled assistant assessor. So Councilor Nato has a motion in there to increase the new position of assistant assessor from $32,136 to $37,000. That was her motion. You seconded for discussion.
To your point, if you're done?
Yeah.
Okay. This is not a position-to-position, apples-to-apples comparison. This is a new position that's been so it is not actually a raise of that same position. So I understand your point that we're trying not to do such high percentages, but I would make the argument that this doesn't really fall into that category.
Any further discussion? Madam Clerk, will you call the vote, please?
Ms. Alves? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zmielewski?
Yes.
Boucher?
Yes.
Motion passes unanimously to now the assistant assessor with a salary of $37,000. Next department, excuse me, any other line items within the tax assessor's office? Here,
yeah, this one.
Mr. President, can I just make one point before you leave this section? I know that you've now taken some action that involves labor. You know, the labor contract and the union. So obviously your action is subject to
union approval
because you don't want to have a situation, I just was talking to the administrator, where the union's taking the position that the clerk's position has to be filled. They have to acknowledge that this transaction is.
So this will be contingent upon the acceptance of dropping of the, yes.
Right, just so that it's subject to agreement with the union. As
okay,
to the.
So I'll make a motion just to make sure. I'd like to make a motion that the new assistant assessor's position is contingent upon clerk position being dropped from the tax assessor's office. This new assessor will be a member of the union. That's a motion.
Second.
Motion seconded by Council Boucher and Council Soli. Madam Clerk, please call the vote, please.
Ms. Alves? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zmielewski?
Yes.
Boucher?
Yes. Okay. I have a question to you, Mr. Excuse me, Mr. Belichick. dealing with education in your department, or people continuing education, are these like online courses that the people may, that your assistant may attend or yourself may attend? Do you feel that, do you find that, will that be adequate?
Yes, that is. That's all I do is online courses.
But is that figure adequate for also your,
yes,
for the new assistant assessor?
Yes.
And including the testing fees?
Yes.
That was coming from contingency.
Thank you, Mr. Belcher.
Okay, any other questions regarding the tax assessor's office? Hearing none. Jason, what's the total now?
It is $121,657.
Is there a motion to approve 2017's budget in the amount of $121,657 for the tax assessor's office?
Mm-hmm.
Moved by Councilor Nato. Is there a second?
Second.
Yes. Second by Councilor Boucher. Madam Clerk, call the roll, please.
Ms. Alves?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Soli?
Yes.
Mr. Zmalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.
Motion carries unanimously. Next.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next item on the town budget is tax collector's office. Councilors, any comment, edits?
I guess I just have a question on the fiscal clerk.
Yes, Councilor.
What that large increase is? And is that a union position, or is that approved with the union?
Close out the town administrator. Who's the administrator?
Jason.
Jason. But he's working with the assessment.
She's commercial of the court.
Yes. Yes. Sorry.
Fiscal clerk.
Yes.
That large increase, and is that also a union position?
It is a union position, and it is a request to go from clerk two to a clerk one step increase. Based on my discussion earlier with the increased duties in the collection department, for me changing over the banks from reg normal deposit to scan deposit, the request was made from the assistant tax collector to me. I do support this based on the fact that I've increased their duties this year, ultimately for, you know, to get our cash in the bank faster to manage it. So I do support this increase for and the change from a clerk two to a clerk one due to the additional workload that's in the department.
Has that already been approved by the union?
I don't know if that has gone through the union process or not at the moment. I can't give you an answer on that.
Town administrator, can you assist us with this?
I'm sorry?
Yes, Town Administrator, here with that.
Did all.
The item under the tax assessor's office, fiscal clerk two, Mr. Parmley told us that, has this been cleared with the union as of yet?
I did not.
No. You would have to approve a contingent upon a negotiation with the union.
I have a question. Mr. Cromwell, you said going from a fiscal clerk two to a one?
I might have that backwards. It might
be
from
a one
to a two. Yeah, I can't.
Either way, we would, just point of order, we would have to do the same thing if we were to move forward on this. Defund the
not if not if that clerk two
promote?
Not if the clerk two is right. I don't have the answer to that question. If the clerk two position is correct on the,
I don't have the contract in front of me now.
Right, but if they're a clerk one now, because this is kind of a promotion, right? So if they're a clerk one now, then the position would become a clerk two. If that person was clerk two, if let's just say that one and two is correct and we have it in the right order. If clerk two were to leave, this is still a clerk two position, right?
It's two to one is what it would be. It would be, this is currently a clerk two that would become a clerk one.
Okay, so that would be the promotion. So, but then this position would be within the budget line item, a clerk one, even if this clerk two person leaves and then another one comes in.
No, I think that would be a choice that the union makes at that point in time.
It's not adding, we won't add another position. We would negotiate with the union to increase the salary to the fiscal clerk one. Or, you know, maybe easier just to increase the salary and not change the designation, you know?
It's getting very convoluted. Who's on
it
first, who's on second? Unions not involved, we don't know if we're creating.
Right.
No, it's just too convoluted. Madam Administrator, good idea. We can look at the salary, keep the title. Now, that is the exact title, correct? That title hasn't changed. It is
correct.
A clerk too. Anybody comment on that?
Just looking at the increase. 14.6.
I'm going to make a motion to increase the fiscal clerk to salary from $32,136, a 5% increase would bring it to $33,743. That's a motion.
Second.
It's a motion and a second by Councilor Boucher. Discussion?
I think it still needs to be contingent on union involvement.
Correct.
Yes.
That
for the salary
part. I think that should be part of the motion.
Yeah, let me retract my. Minimaker retracts the motion.
And Jim, let me retract the second.
Okay, I would like to make a motion to increase the fiscal clerk salary from $32,136. 5% increase to $33,743, contingent upon union acceptance.
Second.
We have a motion, we have a second. Further dialogue? Madam Clerk, would you call the vote, please?
Sal?
Yes.
Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr.
Yes.
Yes.
Any other line items in tax collector's office? Hearing none. Jason, do we have an update of the month?
89,439.
Is there a motion to approve the tax collector's office budget for $89,439?
Motion to approve.
Motion by Councilor Boucher.
Second.
Second by Councilor Nato. Madam Clerk, call the vote, please.
Sells? Yes. Mrs. Nato?
Yes.
Mr. Sully?
Yes.
Mr. Zelensky?
Yes.
Mr. Boucher?
Yes.